Or is it the Marco? Marco's come back onto bait camp.
Yeah, we're tight.
That was on the old rig swimming mullet, hey?
On your right, Matt.
It's starting to get frisky.
Bit my wetsuit.
This episode of the ITM Fishing Show, New Zealand's most awarded and celebrated fishing show, is made available for you to watch right here for free, thanks to our mates at ITM. Good buggers, eh? It was a few weeks ago now that we caught a big shark off the Northland beach and we took that precious DNA sample. And this week we're continuing on with that research. This time though, we've gone from the northeast coast of New Zealand, we've come south to the west coast off of Taranaki, and we're going to be shark fishing. But first, we've got to catch our baits. And the baits come in the form of tuna, hopefully tuna. What do we got, Pete?
Albacore by the looks of it, man.
Albacore, yep, it is too. Oh, nice Albie. Nice albacore. The giveaway for an albacore tuna is those big long pectoral fins. If you don't know what pectoral fins are, the sidey ones.
Look, that's a nice albie.
Hopefully he doesn't fall off when I lift them in. One, two, three. Oh yeah, it's a beauty.
That's a beauty, mate.
Jeez, yeah, the commercial guys love catching those. And the reason the commercial guys love catching them is that they're fantastic eating. Chicken of the sea they're known as, and while I'm very tempted to bleed that one and take it to eat myself, it is destined to be shark bait.
You're there.
Wayne has spotted some bait fish directly below us on the sounder, and what I'm hoping for this time is perhaps some mackerel or something, or some kahawai, just to vary up our supply of bait, because large predatory fish like sharks need a lot of food, and because there's a lot of food around here, look at that, I've hooked up straight away. This is right where we should be fishing for the sharks. I reckon we fish right around here for these sharks, eh?
Oh,
I mean, this water isn't great, but it's not bad, and there's food here. This is the overriding factor. No matter what sort of fish you're looking for, look for their food. And Pete has got some of their food in the form of, looks like a skipjack tuna. That's a nice skippy too. Jeez, that's stunning. Oh, far out. I don't want to straighten these hooks out. I'm going gently, gently. But I don't want to get any more on either. Oh. I'm just trying to...
That's a hell of a school,
yeah. Oh, I know. We've covered 40 miles, and then now in the space of half a mile, we've caught albacore tuna, skipjack tuna, and we're marking big schools of what is these jack mackerel. All three of those things are favourite foods of these pelagic hunters like marlin, and of course sharks.
Marco under the boat.
Oh shit, he's got my baits. He's got my bait. Marco right there. Look at him. Look at him. Nice Marco. Nice Marco. Come up on my baits. Okay, I've got a bait ready. What was I just talking about? Holy smokes. Oh no. See, he's smashed off my other sabikis and that big mackerel. There's Marco sharks here, boys. There's Marco sharks. That's the distress signals that were being put out by those baits. Should start chucking a few bits of chum in the water, eh? Here's a shark. Here's a shark over here. Here he is. He's cruising around the boat. See, there you go. I mean, people would assume that, okay, they're a wild creature. They'd be scared of this big boat, the engine's rumbling. Absolutely not. That shark has picked up the sense, the vibration being put off by that mackerel as I was pulling it in. And now there's the electrical current coming off the boat. He knows that there's food here somewhere. He can sense it and he wants to eat it. Look at him coming right below the boat here. Now that shark has used one of its key sensors, which is ampullae of Lorenzini, which is basically a flash term for electrosensory receptors, which is another flash term, which basically means they can pick up electrical current through their snout, and it's picked up the electrical current or vibrations coming off that bait fish and it's drawn them in. But another sense that they've got is smell. And that stuff there, which is fresh tuna blood, should at least keep them in the area until we can get a live bait rigged up. We don't want to do anything in too much of a hurry here. We want to sort of survey the situation. That's partly because we weren't prepared to catch a shark yet. We're just catching our baits. And what was I saying? Bait here, sharks here. Jesus, love it when you know. You make something up and it actually happens. Is that a blue shark?
It's a blue, mate.
It's a different shark. Well, there you go. That Marco's disappeared and he's been replaced by a blue shark. I mean, we've even got the marine mammals, dolphins feeding all around us. There is food here. There's big predators here, and that's exactly what we were looking for. He'll probably be looking at that camera because there'll be electrical current coming off that camera too. Is that another one out there? Was that a Marco? These dolphins are right here as well. There you go. I mean, just goes to show you that that bait fish that we found here is just the source of so much life. The marine mammals, the dolphins, we've got the birds, we've got the tunas that are here, we've got the sharks, and it'd be a fair bet to say that there would be some marlin hanging around as well. Although it's not marlin today, it's sharks. Big sharks. Well, I hope you're enjoying this classic episode, but if you'd like to see our latest content, action, tips and how-to videos, you can get it all on the Ultimate Fishing app, available now at the App Store, Google Play, or by visiting ultimatefishing.tv. The shark, oh yeah, there he is too. Well, there you go, that's dispelled that myth. Dolphin's going this way, right underneath the Marco shark. Oh, there he is down there. Oh, there's the shark. It's almost like he's chasing those dolphins, isn't he? Okay, now, oh look, I just about dropped the ladder straight onto this, the smaller blue shark, there's another one there. So more and more sharks are turning up, more dolphins are turning up. Oh, and there's a bigger blue shark there. Sharks are all turning up, and of course, this, exactly what you do is you hop in the water, don't you, Blair, with sharks?
Oh yeah, gotta get close to them.
Blair being a spear fisherman inshore, he's used to seeing bronze whalers. However, he said just today that he's never had an encounter with a Marco, so you're about to, bro.
Sweet.
and they're fine. Of course, I'd never ask you to do anything I wouldn't do myself. It wouldn't be fair. In fact, I might get my gear out, actually.
Here we have an aggregation of marine predators. Dolphins, blue sharks, and Marco sharks, all in the same place. But it's not the specific location that's brought them here. It's the conditions. Warm blue water and plenty of bait fish. Never before have I observed so many sharks and dolphins all together at the same place at the same time.
Maybe I should get in there too with them, eh? Or should we get, or do we do live bait camp? We've got too much going on, I don't know what to do. Do I catch a shark and get the research done now? Do we observe them? Because of course we've got to record their behaviour as well. Or do we catch one, or do I go for a swim? Do I go for a swim?
On your right.
Oh, hello. On your right, you're coming in at a good clip. Coming in at a good clip. See, as soon as Blair turned around and faced the shark, you know, that Marco turned off. I mean, they are predators. They're used to having their prey run away from them. Not that I'm any expert, but any time that I've been in the water with sharks and they've come at me, I've gone straight back at them. And there was a good example then. Blair turned around and the shark backed off. Although Blue's come to have a look at him now. Just watch that Blue behind you, Bo. Just give him a nudge if he gets too close. Now, of course, we've got that oil which is trickling away, bringing the sharks in. But of course, the keen senses pick up vibrations of wounded fish. So we are going to put this live bait in the water. However, it's a live bait with a bit of a twist. We're attaching a camera to the line. Okay, there goes our live bait. It's going to tow off our camera. And we've got a balloon on it, which is going to keep that bait near the surface. And oh, look, he's swimming straight under the boat. This is, you know, fairly understandable. He's probably using the boat as cover. Oh look, the sharks have converged right in on that bait. What have we got? We've got a Marco. No, it's a blue shark. They've just picked up those distress signals straight away. And I'm kind of hoping he doesn't eat our camera off. Can't see the Marco at the moment. Funnily enough, you feel much better in the water with sharks around when you can actually see them. When you can't see them, oh man, that bait is freaking out. That shark is after it. That blue shark is after it. Oh, he's got it by the tail. He's taking off its tail. He's taking off its tail. I hope that camera's getting that action. I hope that camera's getting it. Oh no, another shark. Oh no, he's wrapped up in the line. Oh, if he wraps up in the line, we're gonna lose our camera. As soon as he's bitten it, he's got blood in the water and that's really rocked him up. Oh, hopefully that camera's picking it up. I'll try and keep the line tight. If I keep the line tight, we should be able to see a bit better. Yeah! Well, it looks like it's pointing in the right direction. But look, he's just rattling it. That shark's not quite big enough. He's coming up out of the water. Look, he's taking it in half. That bait is still quivering. That'll just be the nerves going through it now. And with that blood and all that quivering going out, that means feeding time. And I'm amazed that Marco hasn't come back. Maybe he's eating Blair. Where is Blair? See Blair? Sweet ass, he's just in the belly trail. He's alright, he's in the belly trail. fresh tuna blood and it's warm. It's actually above the temperature of the water, tuna blood. They're actually a warm-blooded fish, believe it or not, and they have to be just to be able to be swimming constantly through the ocean. They have a really high metabolism, but they are prey to these oceanic sharks. And that one's been annihilated on live bait camp.
Oh, that blue was pretty dopey, eh? He came right up. I had the feeling if I wasn't watching, he might have had to try and have a nibble. Or...
Yeah, concerns me more when the blue sharks turn up with the Marcos, because the Marcos are a little bit smarter, you know? He's going to suss you out. He may suss you out and decide he wants to attack you, which would be bad. But the old blue shark, he tends to figure out what's going on by biting you. And it's not because he wants to attack you, it's because he doesn't have hands. He wants to feel what you are, decide if you're food. And just by testing that out, even if he's wrong and decides you're not food, it's too late, he's bitten you. So that's why you gotta be wary of those blues. Was that the Marco? Marco! Marco's come back onto bait camp. Oh, had a go at it. Oh yeah, see, just like I was saying, that Marco, he's got the strongest senses of all. He's come back and he's got that tuna now, and he's ripped it off, and he's just left our bait cam lying limp in the water, and I want to get that camera back before something eats it, because that might have some very cool footage on it. Is it all in one piece? No bites? You beauty. Oh, I hope there's footage on you. Oh, look at that. Look at those shark teeth, those bite marks on that leader, how close to the camera that he got. And you can see, with very little effort at all, that 500-pound mono, I mean, he barely shook his head, that Marco, and he sliced right through it. It doesn't bear to think what it would do to your flesh.
Yeah, it was what he meant for first, eh? Straight to the camera, had a little lot.
Yeah, they always do, man. I mean, they've got all these sensors going on telling them that there's food here, and there's in the water. Look at that, stunning. Look at this guy. And all these ones over here. I mean, look, that's, what, eight? Look at this guy, brother. Right in here, really aggressive, right on my fin. How are you feeling there, Blair? All right, bro?
I mean, look, there's, what, three,
eight blue sharks here now. It's just too good an opportunity to pass up. I want to get in there, get some footage of them, observe them up close, and if we're lucky, I'd love to be able to film some of these albacore that are swimming around. So, rolling, and you know the rules, mate. No matter what happens, keep rolling.
Here we have eight blue sharks brought in by the smell of blood and burley, as well as the electrical signal being put out by the live baits, but also the electrical current coming off the boat, the camera, and even me and Blair. All of the shark sensors are telling them that there's food here. They can sense it, smell it, and taste it. But what they're seeing is a couple of ungainly humans, and they can't quite figure out if we're food or not. While I'm comfortable touching this shark while it's in an inquisitive mood, the shark doesn't care for the gesture. It simply doesn't see me as a threat, and fortunately, it hasn't decided that I'm food. But as the sharks get more curious, we need to fend them off, because it's just a matter of time until one takes a test bite.
It's so hard to know where to look with our eight sharks around now, and we're at a burley trail, if that wasn't immediately obvious.
We have to pay particular attention to the smaller sharks. They're lower down the pecking order, so they're more aggressive and more likely to take a risk in order to get a feed. And if one takes a bite, it could trigger a frenzy.
Sorry, I want to keep my head down.
But before we can get out of the water and back to the safety of the boat, our mates at TV3 want me to sing a song for a TV advert. So apologies for what you're about to hear.
There ain't no place I'd rather be. La da di da.
On your right. On your right.
There ain't no place I'd rather be.
All right, again, in closer, mate.
There ain't no place I'd rather be.
Got a bit closer.
Come on.
Do the line now.
La da di da.
Underneath you, man. Underneath. Behind you. Behind you.
I love hearing behind you
when you're
in a burley trail with
sharks.
Do the line now.
There ain't no place I'd rather be. La da di da, la da di.
Watch your feet, Claire. Coming from you.
Behind you,
man.
On
your fin.
There ain't no place I'd rather be. La da di da.
They're starting to get frisky.
Don't feed them, Pete. Don't feed them, bro. They're getting aggressive at us, eh?
With my head out of the water, one of the blue sharks rushes in for a bite.
Bit me,
did he?
Bit my wetsuit.
That's him there, that's him.
That little bugger there, he's trying to bite me.
Fortunately for me, the shark's snout was hooked in my wetsuit, and its small mouth couldn't get a grab.
Good light.
There ain't no place I'd rather be. Maybe the boat I'd rather be.
And I came out of it without a scrape. Well, this time at least.
Yeah, enough of observing of sharks for one day. Once they started feeding there, they started getting a little bit aggressive towards us. And all it takes is for one of them to give you a bit of a nick, you start bleeding. And a feeding frenzy is going to happen on your ass.
Well, our burley obviously attracted a whole lot of oceanic blue sharks, and we've got a DNA sample now from a blue shark, but we want a Mako shark. So, to appeal to the more predatory instinct of the Mako, we're going to troll, and that is, we're going to drag this kahawai that we caught a little bit earlier. I've rigged that as a skip bait. We're going to drag that behind the boat, a mackerel and a swimming mullet that I've rigged up, and hopefully that'll spark an attack from a Mako shark.
Swimming mullet, hey? Oh, look at the tail on the skip bait. He's probably been over the skip bait first, so we're talking about a shark here, I'm thinking. And then he's come across and he's eating our swimming mullet. Well, let Pete do the cranky. I've wound it halfway in for you already, bro. Hurry up. Still wanting it in. Okay, Pete. The tag pole's here. We're going to want to bring the fish up over here. You're probably going to have to tag him, mate, if Wayne's going to be on the helm.
It's foul hooked in the pack, so we'll have to be quite gentle with it.
Okay.
It's a Mako shark. To me, about 70 kilos. 70 kilos.
Now, having this fish hooked in the pectoral fin isn't ideal because we won't be able to lead his head where we want it to go. And angry Mako sharks typically don't go where you want them to go anyway. So we're just going to try and bring him up. First things first, we're going to get a pop in a research tag into it. And then we'll try and get him under control and get a DNA sample, eh?
Yep.
Okay, yeah. Oh, a little rat. I don't think that hook's going to come out. He's probably going to get a little bit step up here. Let him go. I just let go of that shark there, two reasons. I didn't want that hook to tear out and damage his pec fin too much. And of course, then he would have gone without getting that research tag, and it would have kind of all been in vain. Oh! Mr. Marco! Mean as sharks, man, I love them, eh? Okay, he's not gonna lead real well, eh? Might be best out of gear, I think, mate, to be honest. Actually, I might spin him into the props otherwise. Oh, yeah. Okay. It was an unhappy little gesture that he gave us there. Take your time, okay. Give him heaps. That fella there is a short fin Mako shark. He's going to have one fin marginally shorter than the others because we're just going to take just a tiny bit of one of his fins for this research. Got him? You beauty. You beauty. Just watch that hook if he rears his head up. Yeah, well done, mate. Beautiful. Hooks out, DNA sample. Oh, did we see what he was? We'll see on the film what sex he was. Oh, hey. See, I'm making an assumption here, eh? They're just so bad and mean looking, they have to be guys, eh? We hope you enjoyed this classic episode. But if you want to see the latest and greatest stuff from all around the world, you can get it all for free at ultimatefishing.tv or by downloading the Ultimate Fishing app.